This video took more than 30 hours to record and edit, and if you're new, make sure to subscribe. It helps me out a ton, it's completely free. Let's also see if the video can get full 20.0 likes. Now enjoy the video. How far can you make it in 100 days of Minecraft Hardcore? This is the challenge I set for myself today. I had only one life, one chance, and one misstep could end everything for my Minecraft world. I had to be careful, but I knew my goal was to make it as far as possible with my limited time. Kill the bosses, get strong armor and weapons, and build a huge base. So I created the world, spawned in, and looked around myself, thinking, another beginning. I had no time to waste on the first day, so I immediately grabbed the berries on the ground facey food, then started chopping trees with 16 of them. I made a wood pickaxe, mined some stone, and made the simple tools that I would need. I plucked some flowers and was on my way. I found things.
You get to live this time.
I found some sugarcane, killed another pig, and found an abandoned nether portal. I felt vulnerable and weak, so I used the iron I found to make myself a trusty shield. The sooner I made myself some armor, the better and the more safe I would feel, so I made pants, then slept on a comfy bed when I came back to the surface. But a zombie had seen me when I had slept. I won and mined the gold box with my new iron pickaxe. Things died. There was a zombie beneath me. I mined down to find him, and there was the cave. With the iron I found, I crafted even more armor. I was not resting until the silver armor surrounded my entire body. I got ambushed, but luckily my shield was with me. In seconds, I found the last bit of iron I needed. I was happy. In the cave were sunflowers, which made me realize the beauty of this area, the sunflower plains I had come to. I wanted to live here. I came up to darkness and slept. Day 3 started out with me clearing grass and sunflowers from my lands. I wanted to set up a farm as soon as possible, so I started clearing out an area. I got water in a bucket and prepared the farm. I was proud of my work, but night was approaching quick, so I lit the area with torches as quickly as possible, then went into the mine to look for epic loot.
More lava, what is this?
Oh. Going into day 4, I finally found it, the beautiful Diamondo. I was full of joy. I knew I was gonna go down here often, so I made tens of stairs, so I wouldn't have to exercise every single time I went up again. I came up to day 5 and saw that some of my crops had grown. I made a small enclosure around a tree and brought sheep in there with my new wheat. I bred them. And watched. I went to explore the lands, kill cows, and found another ruined portal. Fortune 3, gold pickaxe. I was really happy. Death to all cows. I knew I was quicker than the monsters, so I just sprinted on without fighting, and found 3 endermen. They were tough, even with my armor, so I ran to the water and killed them there. My confidence rose, and I killed the last 2. It got really rough.
Oh my god.
But Creeper helped me out, killing the zombies. On the journey, I found a pumpkin, killed more endermen and cows, but by the end of the night, I found a thing I really needed, a village. There wasn't much good loot in the village, but I found a dog that didn't want to be my friend. More work needed to be done to the farm, so I did it. I fed my sheep, they freaked, and it was time to test the Fortune 3 gold pickaxe. But it couldn't even mine lapis, so it was completely useless. Going into day 7, I stumbled into a mineshaft that I started exploring.
Ooh!
I hoped for one more diamond so I could craft an enchanting table and a diamond pickaxe. My speed in exploring these caves kept increasing. I wanted that diamond. I did find a cave spider spawner that I placed many torches around. Day 8, I almost died. 2 cave spiders jumped me. I tried to block off the path, but they went through. Panicked, I climbed the stairs, but a zombie attacked me from behind. I stabbed him, jumped past, and made it out. The poison kept ticking at my health, but my stakes kept my health bar rising. I went back to finish the job. This time I was scared and dug into the wall like a man. 2 jumped me again, but this time I fought with all my strength. But there were 2 spawners, I now realized. I lit up the second one, then dug back to the surface. I ended the day by marking the entrance to the spawners. At my base, I smelted my resources, but I saw a familiar face. I killed it, farmed, and saw yet another creeper. My sheep became yellowed as I dyed them, then I fixed the nether portal. This might be how I died, but I was curious to see where I would end up. I spawned in, and the fortress was right next to me. Scared, and with my shield held high, I entered the building and fought the enemies within. I was set on fire and ran from my life. Everything that the light touched was my kingdom, so I placed hundreds of torches around my land. Here, I found my first zombie villager that I had to kill. I had no potions yet. I upgraded the defenses of my portal and went back. My stubbornness, or was it pride, might get the better of me, but nothing could stop me on my journey. I thought about turning back after seeing this flying skeleton, but Blazes died and I ventured deep into the fortress. And here I found it. 3 more Diamondo. Exactly what I needed. Now my search for diamonds had come to an end. I could craft the enchanting table, so I got the needed obsidian but realized I needed books. Leather was not the issue, but it was the sugarcane. So I ventured into the night, found sugarcane and loot, and a sunken ship. I spent some time to search for the hidden treasure and it had absolutely amazing loot. I looted the shores of sugarcane, killed cows and made it home when it became night. Again, I found a zombified villager. This one, I wanted to trap, so I did so after some struggle. I added the final bookshelf to my enchanting table and with my 35 levels I made a sharpness 4 sword and a fortune 3 pickaxe. Just how lucky could I be? While exploring the nether fortress I had gotten the ingredients for potions, so I healed the zombie villager for cheaper trades and made him into a librarian. In a couple of minutes I managed to get mending, which I was very happy about. I added to my sword and pickaxe, then ran down my mines to look for more diamonds, which I did for the entirety of day 13 as well. Day 14 I crafted my first pieces of diamond armor, a breastplate and boots. With the XP I had gotten from mining, I tried to get good enchants that I would want, but my luck had gone away. Purposefully, I hadn't slept the last couple of nights so that phantoms could finally spawn. I needed phantom membranes to craft slow falling potions, which are very useful for fighting against the Ender Dragon.
Oh my lord.
I fought monsters all night for experience, but could not find any membranes unfortunately. But by the end, I found this guy, who I trapped in a box. I got yet another ender pearl and healed the baby villager. Got a tiny bit more experience from village training and upgraded my breastplate. I was sad because I actually hate thorns. There were 2 enchants I needed now, Feather Falling 4 and Infinity on my bow. The option of Infinity was there, but I needed more experience again. And here is where the nether came in. Mining quartz is a very good way to get experience, so that is what I did. It was unfortunate, since I had mending, all the experience I got was used to heal my mending pickaxe. I passed the bastion, trapped the piglin and started trading for the last few enderpearls I needed to reach the stronghold. Even though I know no redstone at all, I tried to make this automatic sugarcane farm. That kind of worked. It wasn't good, but I was happy I had managed to make this. I yet again ran into the night to kill phantoms, and I finally got the membrane I would need. I also found and trapped another poor man. I gave man an apple, started working on a potato farm by using bone meal, and bred my sheep. I was really starting to get a lot now. The man became a farmer with a reed trade and I traded with him. I went to the nether and made a box around my portal, which really helped me go in and out of the place, since blazes and ghasts wouldn't keep shooting at me. The baby villager had grown, so I moved him together with the farmer. They asked for more space, so I widened their house. I got an unbreaking 2 trade, which made me very happy, but I needed more villagers. In the nether I had destroyed fossils, which gave me a ton of bone meal. Bone meal I used to grow even more potatoes, and potatoes I gave to the villagers, who looked at each other happily now. In the night, I slaughtered enemies until I reached level 30 again. With my levels, I got myself an amazing bow, worthy to strike the Ender Dragon down. I prepared some land for a pumpkin farm and saw my population of villagers had doubled. Nice. This day I prepared for the Ender Dragon fight. I got potions ready, crafted the Eyes of Ender, found a villager child in a composter, and traded my mini potatoes and pumpkins for emeralds. I upgraded my boots, made fireworks, then slept, knowing that tomorrow I would follow the Eyes of Ender and only with an elytra would I be back. There was no going back now. I threw my first Eye of Ender and looked to my greatest challenge yet. Forest I passed, cows I killed. I saw foxes that I had never seen before, until finally the ice turned back. I lit up the area over the stronghold, then mined into the place. In the library I found an amazing Unbreaking 3 book. And while exploring, I saw these drops of lava underneath a room and thought, maybe this was the stronghold room, and it was. With no hesitation at all, I drank my first slow falling potion and jumped into the portal. First step of the Ender Dragon fight is shooting down all the end crystals atop the obsidian towers. My aim was great, although a dangerous combination of Enderman and Dragon's Breath got my health bar very low. This was no joke. I killed the men. Turned back to the obsidian tower, finally breaking the final one. I moved in for the kill and got the dragon to half health. And what the hell happened to my aim? The dragon moved down and I ultimately stabbed it to death with my sharpness 4 sword. I turned to watch the beautiful sight. I had beaten the game. With a torch, I grabbed the egg. I was far from done though. This was not even the most difficult part. I took to the gateway portal and threw my enderpearl into the darkness. The pearl took me to a tiny island I had never seen before. I bridged to bigger lands and jumped with my slow falling. And there I found my first end city. It was beautiful. This pearl was dangerously close, but I made it. I knew I had won as soon as the elytras were on my back. My entire world would change. I would soar the skies. So I entered the ship immediately as I saw it. The loot was amazing. I realized I had no need to create any tools myself, when I could simply raid the end cities all day long.
Oh my god.
With the lights on my back, I felt confident about my journey. I swept through the end dimension for day 24, looting for strong armor, good tools and raw resources. The elytra made the journey very easy as I killed all the shulkers. Before I knew it, I had collected many more elytras.
Oh my god, another ship! Just one feather falling, just one feather falling.
I reached the end portal safely and jumped in. I was home. I deserved a good night's sleep. Day 26 was a day of sorting all the items I had looted in the end cities. The tools were absolutely amazing and so was the armor. I hadn't found an axe though, so I enchanted one with my many levels. I saw this cat that popped out of nowhere and with fish I tamed it. Yeah, his name was Martin and he's very cute.
Oh.
I did a little more enchanting with my high levels from the dragon, got a looting 3 smite mode and got this absolutely trash sword.
What? I... This is trash.
I hate knockback. Knockback 2 is so bad on swords. You just punch away the enemies before you can kill them, which is so annoying. I went back to farming and trading that I loved. The big iron men kind of scared me, so I killed them with my bow. But I felt unsafe in my lands. I had no walls or an infrastructure to defend me. I wanted a castle, and I needed a big flat area to build such a thing. So with my powerful shovels I had collected, I started to dig. I filled up the natural ponds with the dirt I had dug. The terraforming continued into day 28. I chopped some trees as well and started working on an automatic pumpkin farm that I kept working on throughout day 29. To finish it, I needed sand, or rather, glass though. I chose a direction and flew with my elytra. I laughed at my newfound power of flight, but kind of felt like a strong chicken. Yeah, I don't know why I felt like that either. I found the desert and mined the sand and thought that maybe I could find some good loot. I went into the desert temple. I couldn't let the TNT go off, so I ducked down safely. Although I heard this arrow shoot, and on the bottom was a skeleton that activated TNT. My heartbeat accelerated as I bridged up as quickly as I could. The TNT blew up, but I lived through it.
Oh.
All the loot was gone though. I was sad and very, very scared.
Woo.
I realized exploring was too scary, so I went back like a chicken. Trading was very safe and profitable, and I loved giving my adorable mandatory workers attention. For the rest of the day, I dug dirt far into the night. The durability of the shovel was running very low. I did my crops again for day 32, traded, dug dirt, and saw 2 lonely pillagers. They were really, really difficult to kill, but I killed them anyways. These are my lands. No enemies can be on my lands. The area where the castle would be was now ready.
Finished up the terraforming. Puck.
I filled up a bit more holes until nighttime, but I needed slime balls actually. So I moved to a rainy swamp and killed the jumping threats. I managed also to get a music disc that I thought made me very, very cool.
Oh.
Day 34 was the beginning of the castle construction. For the entire day I made an outline for the inner and outer wall. It was looking... interesting. For the next day I started building up the outer wall, which I continued on day 36. However, these guys appeared. I knew I had to fight a raid at some point in my journey, so I decided to step them all down. If I could fight a raid, I could get totems of a dying, which would make my life so much safer. The first waves were very easy to finish, but on day 37 I realized how dangerous this really was. Luckily, a strong Iron Man had popped up and helped me out. For some reason, all the pillagers got stuck in this cave, which made it really easy just to shoot them with my bow. But here came the evokers, the most powerful enemies in this raid. They spawned the Vexes and I was forced to use my most powerful tactic, run. With guerrilla tactics I defeated the raid. I continued the battle and won the battle of the lake.
Woo, baby!
My villagers shot fireworks into the sky and I looked happily into the night. With my muscles sore from the fight, I did my crops and trading, then continued working on the wall. Again, I found a zombie villager that I trapped. I was really getting a lot of villagers now. The wall was looking strong to protect me from the night. I needed wood to make a walkway, so I went to a dark oak forest to chop some wood. These trees were so nice to break. Big, strong, easy to break. Much wood. Yes. At the area, I found this beautiful horse.
Hello, horse.
I tamed her, brought her home, and put her before the entrance to the castle. Kinda like so she could protect it. Her name was Louise. I did some morning farming and worked on the walkway atop the wall, which I continued through day 41. The zombie villager had healed, so I made him a librarian with soul touch, since I need a lot of stone to build this castle, and now I wouldn't have to smelt all my cobblestone in the furnaces. Yeah. It took literally thousands of stone just to make the walls. I went down to mine in my diamond mine and found a lot of diamonds and a lot of stone. The mining session continued for day 43 and I found even more great loot. This should be enough stone, right? I continued building until nighttime and the game just wouldn't stop giving me zombie villager for some reason.
Ah, let's go.
I didn't mind though and trapped this one as well. Wall. Whenever I ran out of stone in my hotbar, I grabbed Louise and got it from my furnaces that had been smelting all along. Day 46, the wall construction was finally finished, so I did what I loved the most, farming. I started working on a redstone piston door, which turned out perfect. What is this? Why is this perfect? It was now time to work on the castle itself. I had cobble, but I didn't have much stone. A good pickaxe was very easy for me to make, since all I had to get was efficiency 4, since silk touch I had for the villagers' traits, and unbreaking I had as well. A big profit, a pickaxe. Behind the castle I mounted on the stone quarry. I placed the stone bricks and slept. I built for all of day 48 and watched the sun set. I had run out of stone and cobble again, so I mined some more. For day 50 and 51 I kept building up the castle. The outside shell was almost done and was looking very cool. I hadn't done my crops in a while, so for day 52 I woke up and started picking the wheat, potatoes and pumpkins. I mined more stone, built more of the castle and then realized that even though I had these big walls to protect me, it was far from safe. And standing at its highest point, I finished building the castle. I went away and looked at what would be my new home. I was proud of my hard work. But what I had built so far was only the outside shell. For day 54, I worked on the indoors all day and started to build up these big pillars to support the structure. Yeah, you guessed it. I ran out of stone again, so I got more day 55. I finished the pillars and the elytra really made it easier when I was this high up. I still had more daytime, so I started working on the bottom flooring for the castle. The work on the floor I continued through day 56. For day 57, I continued working on the inside. I built the staircase which went up to the second floor, mined more stone and slept. 58 and 59 were annoying days, but they were really necessary. I had to move all my messy chests into the castle and then sort everything in a way that made sense. Here it was lucky that I had all these chalker boxes, they were very handy in moving all these items. For day 60 I did my crops again, traded with my villager and built a smelting and potion area in the castle. I was feeling spicy, so for day 61 I started working on this fancy secret entrance to the castle. It was hard to get it right, but I loved it. But enough playing around, I got back to working on an inner pathway for the castle. Working is life. For day 62 I worked all day on the pathway again. As soon as I left the castle, a skeleton shot at Louise. I was shocked and felt her pain, but the sun killed the skeleton before I could. Again, my stone sword was low, so I mined some more, this time with a friend. Do you enter your castle through an entrance like this? Or do you MLG slime block sticky piston epic up into your potion room? Yeah. For the rest of the day, I cleaned my plains of some trees. I mined more tree and terraformed, but not all stayed as it was. To make my land great, I had to take down all my farms. It hurt, but it had to be done. I filled the memories with dirt and gave zombie apple. Now with more land available, I started constructing a farmer's house where most of my money would be made. It needed to be great. Of course, I wanted the cheapest trades possible, so I brewed even more weakness potion, so I could zombify villagers, heal them and get really cheap trades. You may call it scam, but I call it big profit and that is all that matters. Also, I finish up the outside of the house. I quickly did the flooring for the farmer's house and placed the composters. I got every villager I had in a boat, destroyed their cobblestone box, placed beds, then cut down trees. My goal was for zombie to eat the villagers, they become zombie villagers, I heal them. Simple. I made a dirt box, swam the villagers inside with a boat, then let a zombie into the pit.
Oh no. The freak is this?
Surely this wouldn't happen with the next zombie. I killed the Iron Man. The next zombie also led to another golden spawning, but I was done with failing and started spamming blocks to protect the zombie. It worked and I successfully trapped and healed the three villagers. Big profit. I ended the night by placing lanterns outside and inside. I moved the villagers into their new home and I traded for most of the day. I was getting to the point where I was quite rich. However, it was time for a new adventure, so I flew with my elytra and looted the hay bales of an entire village. I looted temples and portals and found epic loot, and then I passed through the coolest area I'd ever found. Flying Islands, a huge cliffside as a half circle with a pond in the center. I loved it. By the end of the day, I found a jungle at long last.
Exactly what I was actually looking for.
I grabbed bamboo, cocoa beans, and melons. On my travels, I found some armor I gave Luis. I needed more money though, so I terraformed a huge area to build even more farms. Day 72, I started building a church that would house my librarian villagers. I built the first cobblestone shill and started building another pumpkin farm. I wanted more money. I finished the farm day 74, I got swarmed by a zombie invasion.
What the frick?
They were weak and slow in the water, so I easily dealt with them. And I got a carrot, finally! I fought skeletons in the night so I could make a lot of bone meal to grow the carrots. My quest for bone meal continued into day 75 where I hunted wither skeletons. I got the first hit quickly then killed so many. It bored me so I went to visit the bastion fortress that I found long ago.
Die, brood nerd!
I immediately fought like any man would, with his bow, never ever getting hit by the enemy. A lot of piglin boots fell to my powerful bow. In my first chest I found ancient debris, and in the treasure chamber I found one netherite ingot.
Oh, let's go.
More wither skeletons died.
Yes.
And I got my second hit. I killed more, made a god scream with my sword and got the last hit I needed.
Oh, let's go.
Three hits to summon the wither boss. Since the wither was a mighty enemy, I upgraded Deathfowler, my smite sword, to netherite. But the battle was long into the future.
Aww. My friends.
I traded with my mandatory workers and achieved my first stack of block of emeralds. The church construction was coming along nicely and the experience from my trading easily healed all my mending tools. The last of the day was spent terraforming.
This is quite perfect because I can just trade, you get the mending on the shovel and just keep using the shovel and every tool. Like, I don't need an XP grinder for this.
Day 78, I needed more stone and cobble, which was perfect and I needed to clear the area anyways. Days were all very similar. Build, trade, build more. I managed to finish the tower of the church in the night. I chopped some more wood in the morning and built the roof of the church. I yet again worked over my bedtime. The church then stood finished, the floor complete and the bell placed. I smashed it a couple of times.
Yes.
It was nice, signaling the completion of this build. Now I needed to move the villagers into the church. I placed their lecterns and beds, then went to get them, and this poor guy.
Oh.
I broke his back with my axe and angered him.
That was not very big brain, was it? I might have to screw.
Moving the other villages was super easy. They just moved on their own.
Oh, these guys are puck.
I traded and got even more blocks of emeralds, but I needed more money. And the best way was melons, so I made a huge melon farm on the area I cleared. I upgraded my axe to silk touch and used bone meal on the melon plants. I got melons to make money, pumpkin from automatic mom to make money, and just money. More melons, more money, 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 money.
No, my friend. Aww.
This poor squid die like they always do. But today I worked on a huge carrot and potato farm. Place the crops, use bone meal to get more until the farm was filled up with both type of crops. To get even more villagers, I gave them a lot of potatoes.
Frick. Go.
I traded. I farmed. I saw child.
Baby.
I moved the children out with both so I could allow zombies to eat their brains. I am just the greatest ruler that exists. I needed more children, so I gave them even more potatoes. For the rest of the day, I started constructing a wall to protect my mandatory workers from zombies. More children had been born, and I moved them to the eating area. When it was all ready, I freed a zombie that ate all of them.
Well, time to eat.
It was tough, but I split all the villagers and healed them individually. After moving back the villagers, I had really good trades. With my huge farms and many villagers, you can imagine the results. My net worth was exponentially rising. I allowed the workers to share the riches being bread.
So you guys want this bread? Because I don't care about that stupid bread.
The tone of my world changed day 90. Today, the goal was to feed the mighty, near-invincible wither boss. I knew it was going to be tough. I knew I had to prepare well. First, I enchanted some items. I got a lot of efficiency 4 on accident, which I put on my pick and axe. The power 4 I put on my bow for power 5. I made strength and speed potion, crafted 11 golden apples, and milked this cow 3 times. My hotbar was ready, I had plenty of time before nightfall. I wasn't confident, but I knew my armor and weapon were strong enough. But if I messed this up, it was all over. My world would be deleted. I took a final breath and spawned into Wither. Yet again used my secret technique, running and shooting with my bow. What else could I do? Tickled away the wither's health without allowing the boss to strike me once until it was time for the melee. Six crits with my sword was all it took to end the beast.
Piece of cake, let's go!
I looked at my health bar and realized I had over-prepared for this fight, but I won anyway and looked to the setting sun with the Netherstein in my hand. I cleared my inventory from the fight and crafted the beacon.
Beacon.
What I love most is farming, so I did my potatoes and traded. My power and riches kept growing. And then, with 164 blocks of emerald, I built a full powered beacon. With my new haste 2 effect and efficiency 5 picks, I easily cleared the last bit of my farming area. It wasn't long until the 100 days were over, so I did more trading and started decorating my lands with lights and paths. To end the day, I went to mine glowstone in the nether to use as decoration around my builds. I placed lanterns by the village and inside my castle for day 93. The glowstone I placed inside the wall. Something I'd forgotten was to make stairs to the walkways of the walls, so I spent day 94 building these. I also needed to do stairs for the insides of the castle, but this was really hard to pull off well, but I ended up being happy about the results.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
The torches looked absolutely horrible, so I exchanged them with lanterns or glowstone and proofed the light areas everywhere so monsters could not spawn. Even after all the effort, a creeper managed to sneak into the tower. I was scared it was gonna blow up my build, so I ran away.
Oh no. Run. Creeper in the house, shit.
Finally, day 97, the castle was completed in its entirety. I gazed over my lands with pride. With a combination of cobble and stone brick, I decorated the paths to end the day off. With 2 days left, I made my workers work even more.
Why is there so many villagers? I don't understand.
I grabbed Louisa to pick up some leaves from a nearby forest, and by adding the leaves by the path, it was starting to look really great. I needed a way to easily get to my farming area, so I built a bridge. This guy watched me and I said hello.
Hello, my friend. How are you?
The final day. 100 days of hardcore Minecraft. I learned a lot about myself and about my lands. I became the ruler of a grand castle and came to lead and protect many people. I wanted to leave a memory of my power, so I created the Pyramid of Emeralds, and atop, I placed my beacon. The sun set as the rays shot into the sky. I had survived and had built a world I was proud of. So that was the video, my friends. I survived for 100 days in Minecraft Hardcore. If you want to see me survive 200 days, then make sure to drop a like on the video. And yeah, please go watch this video. It is really, really, really good. You should definitely go watch it. Also this one. I built a farm and it took a long time. Thank you. Yeah, bye-bye.